Okay. I forgot about that. If you're talking about the Apple II.
Is everything working?
Okay.
Please don't put my slides off.
What can you tell me about this Apple? It's green. Yes.
Nourishing.
Okay, okay, because that Apple is going to fly. Okay, it weighs around about, let's say, 80 grams. It's green, it's round.
80%
carbon. 80%, they've got an engineer there. Okay, well, let me eat the Apple. Now, what has this got to do with architecture? Let me explain to you. I first need to introduce my friends. We're going to talk a little bit about Mr. Isaac Newton. Remember the Apple. We're going to talk about Mr. Ashby, Gauss, Pareto, and Mr. Pearson. Now, if you go through the list, or, and I was very naughty as an academic, I Wikipedia'd the profiles. Sorry, I wasn't supposed to do that, but I did do that. I don't have official references for my information, but if you look at Mr. Isaac Newton, he's been regarded by people as being one of the most influential people in history. He saw the apple from falling from the tree, and from that, he defined gravitation. He also went about and he created three laws of motion. The one is about if I push an object, in order for an object to move, I need to push it, that's his law. First law, the second one is that if something moves at a specific acceleration, it's got a force that it's going to exert. And the third one then is that for every reaction, there's an opposite every action is the opposite reaction. Those of you that are married will recognize our laws. If you look at all behavior, go back, you know, some people need to be pushed to do something. And if you push some people, they are going to do something else. And then I thought about the second one. If you're in business, and that applies that when you play with gorillas, only gorillas play with gorillas in business. Okay, that one about the mass and acceleration. So Mr. Isaac Newton went and he wrote and he formulated a number of physical laws, which I'll show you now on the chart plots. Then Mr. Ashby came around in the 1950s and he wrote a very interesting book around cybernetics and system theory. And he basically defined how we see systems and what we see systems and their relation to complexities. And I think Paul also talked about that. Now, the very interesting law I'm going to show you is the one that he wrote about variety in a business. The variety in the system and the complexity it creates. And I'll show you an architecture how that creates particular issues for you when you're trying to implement the architecture. So Mr. Ashby, about 60 years ago, he wrote a very interesting book around systems. Well, you can actually download that book from the internet. It's very simple to read, but it explains the fundamental principles of systems, complexity, and how they interact. My two famous people, Mr. Gauss and Mr. Pearson. Gauss was the guy who developed the concept of an average. So, and Mr. Pearson then came around and he popularized the concept of a standard deviation. Now, very simply stated that if I want to calculate your average length in the audience, I would measure every person, and then I will add it together, and I will divide it by the number of observations. So let's say for interesting sake that the average length in this audience is 1.7 meters with a standard deviation of 10 centimeters. I can say to you that two-thirds of this audience were either between 160 and 1.8 meters tall. That we derive from the discipline called statistics. So I know that two-thirds of the audience will fit right about between 1.6 meters and 1.8 meters. Then I'm going to show you the type of issues that creates in the world of architecture. Then my very famous friend that I do see every day in the work that we do, Mr. Wilfredo Pareto. What he did was in his life, about 100 years ago, he went around and he did research around who has the most wealth in the world. And very interestingly, he went back to records about 500 years before that in the church, and he did all the calculations, and he found that 20% of the world's, 20% of the people in the world carried about 80% of the wealth in the world. And that fact is always been there, and we've seen it so many times in architecture that there's an 80-20 principle, and then we call it the Pareto principle of 80-20. So those are my few friends. There's some others too, but the ones I want to introduce today to you in an architecture context to show you what they do and how they can help you to simplify your architecture and the success of your architecture in business.